a little bit over a couple of points. And sixth place, Brian Joubert, just a point further back. So anything can happen here, and it probably will. First to go in this final group, the European champion, representing the Czech Republic. A sensational short program he had, and he looked good this morning. This is Thomas Werner, just 21 years of age. Remember last year, finished in fourth place. Could he possibly get on the podium here in Sweden? The music from Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon.
Judges wanted a program that has a purpose, an idea, a concept, and a vision. He's got that within this program.
That's a big one. Quadruple toe loop, hand down, but he made the rotation. That's key. Shame. All credit to it. Second attempt at the quadruple toe. Oh no. It's all going south. That should have been the triple looks. Come on, Thomas.
Come on.
Oh, he's such a fighter. There it is. Ouch. Penny, for your thoughts, mate. That was tough. Well, he kept trying and perhaps tried too hard.
Yep, going for the two big elements with a quad at the start. But it just again and again wasn't working. And then you lose the conviction of the overall routine as well and being able to sell it. And however much this crowd wants you to do well, they just can feel it, sense it. Well, they see it, but they sense it too.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever been anywhere where the crowd have been so supportive of a skater when things are going wrong.
Yes. Yeah, it's lovely, but that was just... Ouch. Yes, he's completely right. Don't want to watch that one back. Because he can generate such excitement with it. The idea of the routine, so good, with the costuming, Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, getting that theme running throughout gives you a platform on which to build the choreography and get that second presentation mark up.
Here's that quadruple toe, good elevation on it, and he'd done everything right there. Little bit tight in the right knee on the way out. If he'd gone down in the knee, it would have given him just that little bit longer to get the left leg back. Here he is again. Didn't quite make the rotation on that. Not sure if he'll get downgraded. That'll hurt him if he does. But to be honest with you, technically, there wasn't enough there to make any inroads in this final group. And even looking at what we've seen so far in the competition, Kevin van der Perren, who leads, remember, he's got that 216.02. There, the Salco, left arm completely gone on that. The jump he can do in his sleep. But you know he's going to be back, and it's all a part of the learning process. He's still only 21. It's character building.
And all the champions know it. You have your ups, you have your downs. It's how you deal with them.
Michael Hook alongside, who will be so supportive. And that's all you can do.
Yep. Some days it doesn't work.
Yep.
But I once talked to Kurt Browning just after the Olympics. He hadn't won the Olympics. He said, "How are you?" He said, "Fine, there's another one coming up."
And I was like a bus,
completely
isn't it?
Gobsmacked that he could deal with it in that way, not be knocked down by it and take it on board. Just the mental toughness that you need to compete at this level.
So where will he end up? Oh dear me, it's not good at all.